let us solve another problem on hexagonal prism. So it is 30 mm sides and 50 mm axis length resting on SP on one of its base corners. So it's a corner condition hexagon such that the top face diagonally opposite corner of the prism lies exactly above the corner on which it rests and the top view of the axis inclined 45 degree will be free. So these are the conditions given for the projection. So let us go and draw the hexagon here with the corner condition. So let me take thickness as 0.4 mm. And is a corner condition hexagon, so I shall start somewhere here, okay, and the length of the side is 30, so I enter 30 in the length option, okay, and 0 degree initially, so I will draw a 30 mm line. So by default the line type is axis here, so I can change right now, and this I can change later. So the length for the second edge is 30 and the exterior angle of the hexagon is 360 by 6 is 60. So first angle, because the first edge was on 0 degree, this is on 0 degree. So second edge is 0 plus 60, so just 60 degree. Okay, for the third edge, it is 30, 60 plus 60, 120. Fourth edge, 120 plus 60 is 180. And again 30 at 240 will give me the proper hexagon required. Then I shall select this particular line and change the line time. So this is a complete top view, so I can just move it a little, select the entire view and you can drag anywhere, it doesn't get distorted. And let us name the corners as we discussed earlier in the sketching. We have two corners here, so let me name this as A bracket A1, this as B bracket B1, this corner as C bracket C1 and this as D bracket D1 and so on. Then I will go for projection lines with the thickness 0.05 on to the XY line. 1, 2, 3 end point to point on element and vertical for all the lines. Then I go for the height, which is 50 mm axis and the lateral edges are parallel, so I go for the lateral edge 50 mm length and perfectly 90 degree 90 I can enter, and I shall draw the top face line exactly aligned to the point. Then I shall draw here and draw another line and draw these two lines. These are the two edges, and all together I will select everything and change it to 0.4 mm thickness because these are visible. Now I can go for the axis. I will draw two diagonals, any two diagonals, so that I will get the center point. From here to here I will draw a projection line. From here to here, that is from the base to the top face, I will draw a line which is supposed to be the axis line with the thickness 0.15. Okay. Now I shall name these corners. I shall zoom this. This corner is A1 dash and this corner is A dash. We have discussed this in sketching. So this is B dash bracket F dash. How I understand is B is nearer the observer, F is exactly behind, because ABCDEF are the top face edges. That's why I'm writing B dash F dash. Similarly here C dash E dash. So I name C dash E dash here, and last one is D dash. So these are the top face edges, so base edges will be accordingly. Now I will name it as B1 dash F1 dash, and here O1 dash also will come, axis O1 dash, and here I missed O dash, so I will name now, and this is C1 dash and E1 dash is not visible, and finally D1 dash. Move it and place them properly. Okay, so the first step is completed, the top view and the front view for a hexagonal prism having the base side 30 mm and height 50 mm. Now the important factor or the condition given for the second step is one of its base corner resting on base corner, that's why I taken corner condition. So d1 dash be the resting corner, okay, the base corner, sorry, the top face diagonally opposite corners, mean this one a dash. So go for a continuous and a thin line 0.05 from d1 dash to a dash. So d1 dash is the resting corner, a dash is the diagonally opposite corner of the top face, okay, that lies exactly above the corner on which it rests. Means now I am supposed to move this, select the entire view, okay, with along with the text, okay, go to move from end point d1 dash, and very close to that you move on the XY line itself. Now I am getting a midpoint there, no issues, okay, but it should be point on element. Then right click and go to rotate option. D1 dash must be the center of rotation. Rotate from this end point, that is A dash, which is supposed to be lie exactly above D1 dash. So you have to rotate from this position, which is the moved position, okay. D1 dash as the center, rotate from A dash to vertical, when I get vertical symbol or a point on element on this line, okay. So click here, this is the condition given, okay. So to free some space here, I can entirely again move this back. So go to move command, move from any point on the XY line to any point on the XY line, provided copy button should be off, copy option must be off. So move very close, okay, this way. And also all the text you have to replace. I'm not replacing all the text, okay, only one text I'll replace, because all the texts are inclined here, okay, there has to be like change with the horizontal text, okay. Now go for the projection, continuous line with 0.05 thickness. First draw projection lines 1, 2 from the top view, 3, only 3 projection lines you have. Now go for the top face A dash, so A dash will be here, okay, as well as the D1. So this will represent 2 points, one is A and then D1, okay, we'll see that later. So go for B and F. F will be on this line and B will be on this line. C and E, E will be on this line, this line, and C will be on this line. D dash, D will be on this line. So I'm getting 6 points here. Let me name so that it will be very clear. So first one is A, then this is B, C, D, this is E, and this is F. So 6 points I have got, which are the top face points. Obtained 6 points in the top view, okay. This is C, this is B. So I can trim off these extra lines, okay. Now I will go for remaining 6 points. So I will go for A1 dash. A1 dash will be here, okay. Then B1 and F1, so F1 will be here, B1 will be here. Then C1 and E1, E1 will be here, C1 will be here. So this is overlapping here, so I shall move this inside the view. And now let me name this as A1, this as B1, this is C1, and D1 and E are same, I told you earlier. This is E1, this is F1. So all the 6 points have been obtained in the top view. So I can rearrange the text position. D1 and E are same. Okay. Now let me complete the top view. So first we go for boundary always. Go for the thickness 0.4 mm and start with the point D. D to E and E to F1 is the boundary. Then F1 to A1, A1 to B1, B1 to C and D. Actually E to F1 there is no edge. So actually it is from E to E1 and F to F1. So both are overlapping. So I am drawing line. So see here, here also B1 to B and C to C1. Okay, they are overlapping. So that is why. Now when you see from the top, okay, for this view, we have to observe, will be see from the top. So what is visible to the observer is the top face A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. So I shall join A to B. B, C, D, E, F is already joined. So F to A. Okay. What else is visible is this edge, which is A dash, A1 dash. So connect A to A1. So other than the boundary, these three edges are visible. How I understand? From the front view. Okay, look at the front view from the top. Okay, now the remaining edges are base edges which are invisible. So I'll change the line type. Okay, so A1, B1, C1 is drawn. Remaining is C1 to D1 and D1 to E1. And also there is an edge called D to D1, D dash to D1 dash. This edge is also invisible. So what I could do is I'll trim off this first, trim the existing line, then I'll draw a new line with the hidden line type. So this completes the view. Now I am supposed to draw the axis. So continuous line with the point 0.05 to obtain the two points from the front view. O1 will be here and O dash will be here, and between that there are two points, but axis I cannot represent because the visible and invisible line is given more preference. That's why I only write O and O1 here, the name of the two endpoints of the axis. So this completes the second step. Front view is rotated in such a way that the diagonally opposite point is exactly lies above the resting point. So D1 dash and A dash are exactly vertically, they lies exactly above. So this way I am getting the view. So now go to the third step. In the third step, it is said that top view of the axis inclined 45 degree to VP. So the meaning of this sentence is top view of the axis means this is the top view. O2 O1 is the top view. So here O dash to O1 dash is nothing but true length, but this O to O1 is apparent length, which is the top view of the axis. So top view inclination is given, beta itself is given. So select the entire view, go to move with the copy on from any point to any point. Okay, move it from any point to any point because nothing is resting on XY line, right? So move it from any point to any point and 45 degree to VP because beta itself is given. So directly rotate. Any point you take it as a center, any point you take it as a reference, okay, and but rotate for exactly 45. Okay, this rotation angle must be exactly 45. Okay, so initially this is making 0 degree, rotate 45 this way. You can check this. So now it is already all selected and you are in the select mode. You can drag anywhere at this time. You can drag and place wherever you want. Okay, in such a way that it is not crossing the XY line, is also not going out of the sheet. Okay, and you can check now the axis inclination with respect to XY is 45 degree. Okay, now let me zoom so that it will be more clear. And to obtain the front view, draw the projection lines, see that the line is continuous and 0.05 is. First go for the top face, A dash horizontal, B dash horizontal, C dash E dash horizontal. The line must be perfectly horizontal. Okay, now where is A, B, C, D, E, F? A is here, so project up to A dash, project up to A dash. B is here, project up to B dash, project up to B dash. C, project up to C dash. D, project up to D dash horizontal. And this endpoint E, project up to this. Okay, so I am getting A, B, C, D, E, and finally F. F will be on this line. Sometimes you may not be able to project the lines properly. Okay, the earlier it happened. So point on element and vertical. So these symbols are very important. The line projection lines which you are drawing are perfectly must be perfectly vertical and exactly till the line. That is very important. So trim off this extra lines, okay, because all these edges will come before that. And now name all the points. So which we have named, like obtained right now. This is A, B, C, D, E. Sorry, all are dash. Because the front view points A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash and F dash. Okay, so this is how you get 6 points first. Okay, now go for the another 6 points. So first draw A1 dash line. A1 is here, so this way also you can go for. Okay, so the alignment indicator, what is like exactly like visible right now, this way also you can go for. This is another way of getting A1 dash. Similarly, I can go for B1 dash. B1 is here, come take the cursor here, then move above horizontally. So I am getting the alignment indicator exactly vertical to B1 dash horizontal. So I can join to B1 dash. So this is how I got B1 and A1 dash very easily. I go for C1. C1 is here. Okay. C1 dash, then join to C1. So this will save the time. This is another way. So earlier I told you one way, this is another way of getting the points. D1 dash is here. So D1 dash is, this A is already projected. So this intersection of XY line and A vertical itself is a D1 point there. Then we'll go for E1. For E1 already we have the horizontal line, just draw a vertical line. Now look, here you cannot be able to draw the perfectly vertical line. So you are supposed to draw a, you are supposed to zoom this. So this is E vertical. If you zoom, you will get exactly the point on element and vertical line exactly till there. Then zoom further. So E1 is over. Last one is F1. So F1 dash. F1 dash is here. Point on element and vertical. Now let me name all the points. This was A1 dash. Then B1 dash. This time consuming because we have a lot many points in a hexagonal prism. We have 6 plus 6, 12 points. That's why it is little time consuming. So this is the D1. So D1 dash is exactly on the XY line and from this point. Then we have E1 dash and F1 dash. If you want, you can again select the text and you can drag and move a little. Okay, this is E1 dash and this point is, this one is E1 dash. Okay, now let us apply our rules. First you go for boundary, go for count continuous line with a 0.4 mm thickness. Okay, so what is the boundary? Now look here, we have two lines here, one is D'D1', other one is C'C1'. We do not know which is on the boundary. Boundary in the sense it should be outermost. So let me try with the D'D1'. Okay. This line intersects the XY line. So this is D1'. Now if I join D'D1', what is happening? So I can see the C1' is outside the boundary. So I should not draw this. Why I am drawing D'D1'? Because it's a lateral edge. I cannot connect D1' to C', such edge is not existing. So I have to go for C1' to C' now. And now I can observe D' is inside the boundary. So that is how I can understand. Now from C' to B', B' to A', this is a very clear boundary. Now A' to A1' itself I have to connect. Okay, I cannot connect A' to F1'. Okay, or I have to connect A' to F'. Now what happens if I connect A' to A1', this F' is outside the boundary. So I cannot connect A' to A1', so I have to connect A' to F' first. Then from F' I must connect F1', because I cannot connect F' with A1', such edge doesn't exist. Okay, so existing edge means A', A1', B', B1', such that the lateral edges only exist. F1', so F1' to E1' is the base edge. Then to D1', okay, D1', now I can connect C1', because C1, D1 is the base edge. So this is the boundary. So little complicated to understand initially, but once you practice, is not much difficult. Okay, now what is nearer the observer? Near the observer is, if I rotated in the other way, so anti-clockwise, so I got A1, B1, C1 is very closer to the observer. So that means the base is very closer, or base is visible to the observer. So I shall connect the edges F' A1', the base edge, A1' to B1', and B1' to C1'. C1, D1 is already connected, D1, E1 is already connected. So entire base is connected, all six edges are there. So what else is visible? I can see here C1 is already connected. Okay, remaining is B1 and A1. So definitely B1 and A1. So A1 is here and B1 is here. Both are nearer to the observer. So A' to A1' I must connect. Then B' to B1' I must connect. Okay, so these are the visible edges. I can see here one thing, all the lateral edges are parallel to each other, okay, and also parallel to the axis. Now, I will go for invisible edges. Invisible edges are the top face F dash to E dash and E dash to D dash, okay, D dash and D dash to C dash. So, as well as D dash to D1 dash is also not visible, and E dash to E1D is also not visible or invisible. Finally, I go for the axis, go for 0.05 mm projection line, and O1 is here on this line. Little difficult to project it. So, draw the horizontal line first for both O dash and O1 dash. Then you can go for, actually this is the midpoint, otherwise I should mark this properly, on this line. So I shall zoom this. This is my line, point on element, and I can trim this extra part of the line. Go back, take a line from this midpoint and project on O dash horizontal. I'm not getting it. Zoom it and trim off the extra part. Now I can draw a line for, take a line, take axis, go for 0.15, and from O dash to O1 dash. So this is the axis. I shall name this point as O1 dash and this point as O dash. So this completes the drafting of a hexagonal prism when the conditions are given as is resting on one of the base corner and the diagonal opposite corner lies exactly above, so it is the front view and top view, and the axis is apparently inclined at 45 degree, top view of the axis 45 degree to VP.